Today's we are going to cover the panel sections from component sections. Make sure we are working on code Bootstrap 3 series, because before starting Bootstrap 4 you have to familiar with Bootstrap 3, and I consider that you have the basic knowledge of HTML and CSS if you are watching this lecture. So in the previous lecture we learned how can you create your list group. Okay, so now I'm saying that I'm commenting, or I'm going to comment this sections. Now I'm saying how can you create your panel. So what is panel? For suppose you want to add some content inside a header, so that's why you can use your panel. First of all, use panel class, and I'm saying panel, and I'm saying default. I'm going to use the default here. Okay, so what you need to add the content for your panel. For suppose I'm saying this is my panel body, by specifying a class panel body. Okay, so here is your body, basic panel body or item. Go to your page, refresh the page, make sure which page, index.html, and I have created index.html inside my Bootstrap folder. And where is the Bootstrap folder? Available inside my E drive. Okay, so refresh the page, you have your basic by default panel. So this is your panel, and now you can add something. This is your panel body first of all, and if you want to specify the panel heading, for suppose I'm saying this class panel heading. Okay, so now I'm saying my panel heading is, this is my panel heading. And now what you need to give it a class. I'm saying panel title. Okay, so in the panel title you have defined the panel heading, you have a panel body. So it's totally dependent upon you. Go to your page, refresh the page, you have now panel body. Oh sorry, you have now panel title, and now you have the panel body. So how can you create, so this is your panel. For suppose you want to show a particular information, for suppose the pricing and the basic list, or the necessary requirement of your pricing, or whatever you want to add inside the panel. For suppose if you need the footer sections, what you need, you just need to add a class. I'm saying panel footer. And now you can add your something here, or whatever you want to add. Okay, so now you have your panel footer. So in this way you can add the panel as well. Okay, so now I'm saying this is the panel. First of all, this is the panel primary. What you need, if I'm saying this is the panel info, go to your page, refresh the page. So now you have your info, and you can also change this with your warning or your danger and something like this, which is similar with your button. So for suppose this is a primary button, if you can change the background of your button, you just need to add a class which is button danger, button success, whatever you want to add. So it's similar with buttons. Okay, so what happens if you want to add the table inside your panel? For suppose this is your footer sections, so this is your body, and I'm saying this is my table, and I'm saying table, and I'm saying bordered. So here is my tr, and here is my td. I'm saying 1 copy this bad boy, and I'm saying this is 2. Go to your page, refresh the page. So now you can see you have added your you need to define also inside here. So now you can see you have added your table inside the panel body. So it's totally depend upon you. You are going to add a table or you are adding image or something like this. Refresh. So now you have image, because we have image. So this is a large image. So what you need, you need to specify my logo class. So now you have an image. So it totally depend upon you which approach you are using or you are going to use. So I'm saying first of all, in the panel section, for suppose you want to add the list group. And how can you create the list group? If you have remembered, for suppose I'm saying list group and now I have an li, and now I'm saying list group items. Make sure in this time I'm saying success, not success. I'm saying list group item. Okay. So now I'm saying this is 1, copy this bad boy, paste this bad boy here. So I'm saying this is 2, and I'm saying this is 3rd. Go to your page, refresh the page. So now you have created the basic list group. So you can define each and everything inside here. It's totally depend upon your requirement, or it's totally depend upon your approach, or you need. So I think this is enough for today. In the next lecture we are going to cover the responsive, and we are going to cover something something from the component section. So we are going to finalize our component sections in the later lecture. So thank you for watching.